Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Blessed is that man. Blessed is that man. Blessed is that man. Don't walk and don't stand and don't sit in sin, in cynicism, or in the language of sin and the talk of the world and the ungodly, or you will not be blessed. Oh, are you giving us an ultimatum? Yes, that's exactly what God does, is give you an ultimatum. He backs men in a corner and forces their hand. Choose this day whom you will serve. And the young rich ruler said, I'm not quite willing to go quite all the way. Well, shouldn't we counsel him and pamper him and baby him? No, not Jesus. He says, get out of here. Get lost, mister, to the young rich ruler. You cannot be my disciple. It's amazing how many times Jesus said that. It's either this or get lost. You cannot be my disciple. That's the word of God, folks. Jesus gave people an ultimatum. For his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he must meditate day and night. I think I'm going to conclude down on the floor. It's much cooler. There's one thing I'm going to read that I doubt that any of you people know is in the Bible. I would call it the most shocking passage of Scripture in the Bible, and I'm going to close with that. Now watch this. David is a man after God's own heart. David is king over God's people. David is the most powerful anointed man in history of the Old Testament. When he was 12 years old, 13 years old, he took a bear that had come to get some lamb chops. Then he went after Goliath, 13 feet 4 inches tall, and slew Goliath. He was a warrior. He was a man's man. He was fearless. He was a man after God's own heart. And he was a songwriter. He was a musician. He could play so skillfully that the penetrating force of God, the steel punch of God, would drive demons out of the king when he played. He was everything. And there was nothing he couldn't do. He was the most talented man in recorded Bible history. He was everything. And he was a man after God's own heart. But oh, did it cost him to write. As he opens the book of Psalms, blessed is the man. He can hardly wait to get to verse 2. Folks, I want to tell you right now what's going to happen if you touch the world. I want to tell you right now, if you sit around and be idle, don't let any idle time come your way. Stay praying. Stay in the word. Don't let it depart out of your mouth. You got to be radically, radically committed to the cause of Christ. You've got to be consumed and obsessed with Jesus. Give no place to the devil. God, don't do it, man. It'll cost you everything.